Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This video will be discussing on how to solve equations involving indices. There are generally two types of equations involving indices. The first one is equations with the same base. The second one is equations with different bases. We will discuss how to solve equations of indices with different bases after discussing log in chapter 1.3. Focusing on equations with the same base, to solve this type of equation, we're going to use two methods. The first one is by comparing its power. The second method is by changing it into quadratic equation. Let's look at the first example. We are given 3 to the power of 2x minus 3 equals to 81. First thing to do is to recognize its base. On the left side here, we have base 3. On the right side here, we have 81. We know that 81 is equal to 9 squared. And we know that 9 is equal to 3 squared. Therefore, we can rewrite the equation as 3 to the power of 2x minus 3 equals to 3 squared to the power of 2. Let's simplify this a bit more. So we have 3 to the power of 2x minus 3 equals to 3 to the power of 4. Now we know that both left and right side has the same base. And because we only have one index on the left and one index on the right, and they both have the same base, we can use the first method that I mentioned earlier. We can compare its power. So this power here and this power here. By comparing, we can have 2x minus 3 equals to 4. And suddenly, this is very easy to solve. So we have 2x equals to 7. And lastly, we have x equals to 7 over 2. Now this looks scary, but don't be. I'll guide you through it. Remember our first step from the previous slide? The first step to know is to recognize its base. But to recognize the base, you need to recognize which one is the index. Now this is an index, and this is also an index. And these two indices look similar, except for this power 2 here. By law of indices, I can rewrite this as 2 to the power of x to the power of 2. So let me write the question again with this new information. So 2 to the power of x to the power of 2 minus 12, 2 to the power of x plus 32 equals to 0. Now you would think, this does not look any easier. But what if we substitute 2 to the power of x equals to a? Then the equation now will be a squared minus 12a plus 32 equals to 0. Now you see that this is just a quadratic equation. And to solve this quadratic equation, you need to factorize this to become a minus 8, a minus 4 equals to 0. And now we have a minus 8 equals to 0 and a minus 4 equals to 0. And then we have a equals to 8 and a equals to 4. But we don't want to find a. We wanted to find the value of x. So we're going to substitute it back. So 2 to the power of x equals to 8. And 2 to the power of x equals to 4. You know that 8 is equals to 2 to the power of 3. And you know that 4 is equals to 2 to the power of 2. And again, both sides has the same index. And this one too has the same index. And again, by comparing its power, therefore, here x is equals to 3 and here x is equals to 2. Now, let's test you. Don't pick. Pause this video and try these two questions. When you're finished, you can continue this video and we'll check your answers. Pause now, I'll wait. Ready? Let's check. The first thing to do is to recognize the bits. So we're going to change 49 and 343 into base 7. Let's rewrite the equation here. We have 7 to the power of x plus 2 over 7 to the power of 2 to the power of x equals to 7 to the power of 3. Now simplify the left side here. It will become 7 to the power of x plus 2 minus 2x equals to 7 to the power of 3. And this one becomes 7 to the power of 2 minus x equals to 7 to the power of 3. So by comparing, we have 2 minus x equals to 3. Then minus x equals to 1. And lastly, x equals to minus 1. Good job. Next question. We can rewrite this as 3 to the power of x to the power of 2 equals to 6. 3 to the power of x plus 27. And if you can recognize this, this one looks like a quadratic. Let's substitute 3 to the power of x equals to a. So we have a squared equals to 6a plus 27. We're going to make this equal to 0. So we are going to move 6a and 27 on the left side. A squared minus 6a minus 27 equals to 0. Next, we are going to factorize this. So a minus 9, a plus 3 equals to 0. So a minus 9 equals to 0. And a plus 3 equals to 0. Let's look at this solution first. A is equal to 9. We don't want to find the value of a. We want to find the value of x. So you're going to substitute 3 to the power of x back again. So 3 to the power of x is equal to 9. And we know that 9 is equal to 3 squared. So by comparing its power, here we have therefore x is equal to 3. Now look at this solution here. We have a equals to minus 3. Again, for the same reason, we're going to substitute 3 to the power of x again. So 3 to the power of x is equals to minus 3. We're going to reject this solution. Why? Because the positive base cannot be equal with the negative base. So this is the end of chapter 1.1 on indices. Thank you for your attention and see you on the next video. Have a great day. Take care.